So we're speaking about Lord Shiva. Gop Kumar is asking about Lord Shiva because he's not familiar with Lord Shiva.
我们现在讲的是主Shiva。
So Nandeshwara describes that this Lord Shiva is worshipped by liberated souls and he's very dear to the devotees, to the Vaishnavas. So Lord Shiva has a very intimate connection with the Supreme Lord Krishna. Lord Shiva himself is a great, he's also the Lord of the universe, he's also like Bhagavan. But he teaches his own devotees that the goal of life is greater than simply worshipping him. That they should worship the Supreme Lord Vishnu. So, Lord Shiva helps people to develop devotion for the Supreme Lord. So all the devotees of Lord Vishnu are happy to get the association of Lord Shiva, and he's very dear to them. Now, one of the friends of Lord Shiva is Kuvera, who is the treasurer of the demigods. So, Nandeshwara said that Lord Shiva is traveling with his wife Parvati and his companions, and they're going to go to Kailash. And there they will meet Kuvera. And he said, Lord Shiva has just come from his own planet, which is transcendental, Lord Shiva is transcendental. His abode is also transcendental. And the people who go there, they go there by devotion. And they have to understand Lord Shiva and Lord Krishna to be non-different.
人们只能透过奉爱才能去那个居所，并且人们必须要明白主Shiva和主Krishna没有区别。So
Lord Shiva's planet is beyond the covering of the material universe.
主Shiva的星球超越了宇宙物质宇宙的覆盖外壳。And
you have to go there. To Lord Shiva's abode, you have to worship him and Lord Vishnu on the same level. So Lord Shiva's abode is eternal and it has opulence, great opulence. And Lord Shiva's friend is Kuvera, and Kuvera, where Mount Kailash, that's the property of Kuvera.
Kuvera's
Kuvera worships also Lord Shiva. He has great devotion for Lord Shiva. And Parvati, Lord Shiva's wife, is the mother of the universe. She's Lord Shiva's supreme energy. So he tells Gop Kumar, you should not be surprised to see her sitting on the lap of her husband in public. But Gop Kumar wondered, when Lord Shiva is so great, why he only has a few people with him? If he's so great, you would think he would have many, many more people with him, but he only has a few people. So it's explained that this is only for this. Lord Shiva does have many devotees, but he only brought a few special devotees with him for this trip. And this place where they're going, Kailash, is within the material world. It doesn't have enough accommodation for all the devotees of Lord Shiva.
So this Kailash is within material world?
Yeah.
Oh, 而且呢, 他被告知, Kailash 是在物质宇宙之内, 而这个地方容纳不下那么多的人。
So when Gop Kumar heard all of this, he was very happy and he was eager to get the blessings of Lord Shiva. He wanted to understand how Lord Shiva is not different from Madan Gopal. Gop Kumar, he's a devotee of Madan Gopal, but he was also attracted to this amazing person, Lord Shiva. Yeah, he was seeing Lord Shiva for the first time, so it was a great shock to him, but he was so very attracted by him. So Lord Shiva, he is cognizant, he understood everything, he could read the thoughts in the mind of Gop Kumar.
明白他心通,
and Lord Shiva gave a glance to Nandeshwara, telling him, Nandeshwara, that you explain everything to this Gop Kumar. And so Nandeshwara explained to Gop Kumar how Lord Shiva and Madan Gopal are not different. So this Nandeshwara, we should understand that he is the principal attendant of Lord Shiva.
我们要明白,
But Lord Shiva also has a carrier. His carrier is a bull, and that bull is also known as Nandi.
主 Shiva 呢，还有一头坐驾，是一头公牛。这头公牛的名字呢，也叫 Nandi。
That Nandi is a partial expansion of the Supreme Lord。
那位 Nandi 是尊主的部分扩展。
So, Gop Kumar understood that Lord Shiva was not different from Madan Gopal.
勾帕库马尔便明白了，朱希瓦和马丹勾帕是一个人。
And at the same time, Lord Shiva promotes love for the Supreme Lord. He encourages people to devote themselves to the Supreme Lord.
与此同时，主 Shiva 扩展，就在宇宙之中推广了对至尊主的爱，奉爱。
So there's nothing wrong with being attracted to Lord Shiva, because he's not different from Lord Krishna.
被主 Shiva 所吸引没有什么错误，因为主 Shiva 和主 Krishna 没有区别。
So you give devotion to Lord Shiva, it's also devotion to Krishna.
对主 Shiva 给予主 Shiva 奉爱，也是对主 Krishna 给予的奉爱。
So if we satisfy Lord Shiva with pure devotion, Lord Shiva will help us to become more devoted to Lord Krishna.
我们通过纯粹的奉爱满足主 Shiva， 主 Shiva 会帮助我们获得对 Krishna 更多的奉爱。
So in this way, Gop Kumar, he became one of Lord Shiva's companions, and he became friendly with all the devotees of Lord Shiva.
就这样， Gopa Kumar 就成为了主 Shiva 的同伴之一，而且和主 Shiva 的奉献者们都很熟悉了。
And he heard from all the devotees of Lord Shiva how Lord Shiva has one eternal transcendental form.
他从主 Shiva 奉献者那里听说，主 Shiva 拥有一个永恒超然的形象。
And he has his own abode, and he is always visible to his worshippers who live there with him. The people who live on his own abode, they can always see Lord Shiva there and worship him.
那么在他自己的星球上，那些崇拜他的崇拜者们随时都可以看见他。对于他崇拜者而言，就是他的那个居所的居民呢，随时可以看见他。
So you could, we can see the difference between Lord Shiva and Lord, just like.Gop Kumar is in this Mahakalapur, so Lord Mahakala is not like Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva has only one form, but Mahakala, sometimes he has a form, sometimes he's without form.
所以我们可以看到这个区别，这个地方呢是 Mahakalapur，Mahakala 无相主 Shiva。主 Shiva 呢，他是有总是就有一个形象，但是 Mahakala 有时候有形象，有时候又无形无相。
And he doesn't Lord Shiva doesn't expand himself like Lord Vishnu does.
主 Shiva 也不像主 Vishnu 那样会扩展他自己自身。
Lord Vishnu appears in so many different forms, sometimes as a fish, sometimes as a turtle.And sometimes a half lion, half man, so many different forms.
主 Vishnu, 他有时候将自己显现为一条鱼，有时候是乌龟，有时候是半人半狮形象。
So Lord Shiva's pastimes are performed for the pleasure of his devotees. Sometimes he may disguise himself.
主 Shiva 是为了他奉献者的快乐，来展示他的消失光。但有时候他又隐藏自己的身份。
And just like sometimes he may disguise, he may become a hunter or a fisherman.
有的时候呢，他在将自己假扮成一个猎人，或者是一个渔夫。
But he never transforms himself into these different species of life.
但是他却从来不会把自己的形象，变成这些不同的物种。
So, because Lord Shiva doesn't change his appearance, the followers of Lord Shiva are always happy and satisfied with him.
因为主 Shiva 从来不改变他的形象，他的支持者们对他都感到非常的高兴满意。
And he is always, they always see him on his planet, not like Lord Vishnu, who often leaves his place.
而且他们总能在主 Shiva 的星球上随时见到他，不像主 Vishnu 有时候会离开他自己的星球。
So, you can see the difference between the worshipping Lord Shiva and worshipping Lord Vishnu.
所以你们可以看到崇拜主 Shiva 和崇拜主 Vishnu 之间的区别。
Right, there's many devotees of Vishnu and different incarnations of the Supreme Lord. It appears in different forms.
主 Vishnu 有很多的奉献者，他有各个化身，他作为至尊主，他有各种形象。
Sometimes they can see the Lord, sometimes they cannot.
有时候他的奉献者能见到他们的主，有时候却见不到他们的主。
But devotees of Lord Shiva, they can always see Lord Shiva.
而主 Shiva 的奉献者是随时都可以见到主 Shiva 的。
Right, and Lord Shiva's body is always spiritual. It's not subject to change. It's eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
主 Shiva 的躯体是灵性的，而从来不会变化，它是拥有的永恒知识和极乐的躯体。
And it's beyond the material creation.
它超越了物质创造。
So with his devotees, there was festivals. Lord Shiva was taking part in singing and dancing, and this way, they were showing their devotion for the Supreme Lord.
主 Shiva 和他的支持者们一起唱歌。就在你这种方式来向至尊主表达奉爱。
Yeah, Lord Shiva wants to encourage his followers to also develop devotion for the Supreme Lord.
主 Shiva 也鼓励他的奉献者们发展对至尊主的奉爱之情。
So Lord Shiva was taking part in the singing and dancing and calling out the names of the Lord.
主 Shiva 就参与着唱歌起舞，呼唤至尊主的名字。
So Lord Shiva would have these kind of festivals just to encourage his followers, his people, to worship Lord Vishnu as not being different from him.
主 Shiva 就这样的，发动了这些节日，鼓励自己的支持者们崇拜跟他自己没有区别的主 Vishnu.
But Lord Shiva himself is a devotee of Vishnu, that he has all devotion of Vishnu.
但是主 Shiva 他自己是主 Vishnu 的奉献者，怀着对 Vishnu 的奉爱。
Yeah, so Lord Shiva is an empowered incarnation of the Lord, and he comes in the role of the Lord's devotees.
主 Shiva 是主 Vishnu 的被授权的化身，他以主 Vishnu 的奉献者的角色前来。
So he's called a Bhakta Avatar, one who is giving devotion, teaching devotion, incarnation of devotion.
所以主 Shiva 的一个名字叫 a Bhakta Avatar，
<Yeah.
S 2> 是赐予奉爱，是奉爱的化身。
He's the Lord of the universe.
他是宇宙之主。
And the favorite form of Lord Shiva is the form of Lord Shesha, who has 1,000 faces. Right, Shesha is, you know, like, you know, Shesha is a form of a snake. So Lord Shiva has a special feeling, special affection for Ananta Shesha. Ananta Shesha is an expansion of Lord Sankarshan. And just as Lord Shiva is in charge of the mode of ignorance, Shesha is also one of the lords in charge of the mode of ignorance. It's described that there's a place in the universe called Ilavritavasya. And Lord Shiva is surrounded by 10 billion maidservants of Goddess Durga. And they are all there to serve Lord Shiva. So Sankarshan is part of the Chaturvyuha. There are four forms of the Supreme Lord, and Sankarshan is the fourth expansion.
至尊主呢，他有四重扩展，三。
And Sankarshan expands in the form of Ananta Shesha.
Sankarshan 就将自己扩展为 Ananta Shesha.
So Lord Shiva knows that the cause of his own existence is Lord Sankarshan. Lord Shiva comes from Lord Sankarshan.
主希瓦就很清楚，他自己存在的源泉是三卡山，来源于三卡山。So
he always meditates upon Lord Sankarshan.
他恒常冥想三卡山。And
Lord Sankarshan has this form of Ananta Shesha, which has 1,000 hoods. 1,000 hoods, you know, a big serpent with 1,000 heads. But in Lord Shiva's abode, is the region of Ahankara, the region of false ego. And there, Sankarshan has four arms.
主Shiva的居所是 假我的居所，在那里，安卡尔的居所，在那里呢？三卡尔山，它是四臂形象。
So, Lord Shiva's abode is a very special place.
主Shiva的居所是一个特殊地方。
So Gop Kumar, hearing about Shiva Loka, was very happy, but still he was not satisfied.
Gopa Kumar 听到主 Shiva 的 Shiva Loka， 他非常的满心满，非常的高兴，但是他内心呢，并不是很满足。No,
he was eager to see Shiva Loka, but he was more eager to know about Madan Gopal.
他很渴望了解 Shiva Loka， 但是他对于 Madan Gopal 呢，更为青睐。
So he remembered the mantra which had given, been given to him by his guru. And this way, by remembering the mantra from his guru, he could understand the situation which he was in. He realized he had forgotten the lotus feet of Madangopal. He'd forgotten about Madangopal's pastimes and all the attractive features of Madangopal. So Gop Kumar told his, he talked to his own mind. He said that Lord Shiva performs these wonderful pastimes in the form of Lord Gopal. Because they're non-different, right? So Lord Gopal's pastimes must also be Lord Shiva's pastimes.
因为他们俩没有区别，对吧？所以，Gopal的消时光也一定是主Shiva的逍遥时光。
But still, the mind of Gop Kumar was not peaceful yet.
但是Gopal Kumar的心意仍然没有平静下来。
So then Gop Kumar spoke to his mind that if you see something, if you don't see something in Lord Shiva, if there's something lacking in Lord Shiva, it must be the very special sweetness of Gopal.
然后，于是Gopal Kumar就对他的心意讲话了。如果你在主Shiva身上没有看到什么的话，那一定是Gopal的特殊的甜美了。
Gopal's beauty and Gopal's wonderful qualities are very rare, very sweet. You won't see them in Lord Shiva. But by Lord Shiva's mercy, you will soon fulfill your desire.
但是极致主Shiva的仁慈，您将很快满足您的心愿。
Yeah, because by the blessings of Lord Shiva, you will fulfill this desire to see Lord Madangopal.
因为通过主Shiva的祝福，就能很快实现他的祝愿，见到Madangopal。
So in this way, Gop Kumar's mind became peaceful, and he stayed for, he was happy to stay at the side of Lord Shiva.
就这样, Gopal Kumar很快便心平气和下来,他便留在了主Shiva的身旁。So
Lord Shiva decided that he would take rest at Mahakalapur for some time before going to Kailash.
主Shiva决定在去Kailash之前要在Mahakalapur休息一段时间。
Gop Kumar wondered why he's taking rest, what's happening?
Gopal Kumar感到很纳闷，他为什么要在这里休息呢？发生什么了？
But then he soon found out, because then from a distance he could hear a group of people coming, and they were singing beautiful songs, and the sound was very sweet and very pleasing. So when Lord Shiva heard the sound, when he heard the people coming, then he became ecstatic, and his his love for Krishna awakened. He began to dance, all just on his own. He got up and he began to dance in ecstasy.
当主Shiva听到远远来的这一群人在那里唱歌，他就狂喜起来，对Krishna的奉爱又唤醒了，他就立即起身开始跳起舞来。
And Lord Shiva's body was trembling, and he was choked. His voice was choking. His body, he was perspiring, and his hair was standing. Bodily hair was standing on end. He'd fall on the ground.
主Shiva呢，他现在呢，他就毛发直竖，他浑身颤抖，声音哽塞，浑身大汗淋漓，他倒在地上。
And he started to dance. Although he was the only one dancing, he started to dance.
而且他还开始起舞，虽然他一个人，他也在那里跳了起来。
So his Lord Shiva's very faithful wife, Lord Shiva has a very, very faithful wife, she's very chaste. And all of the companions of Lord Shiva, they also became enthusiastic and they began to play music and they began to chant the names of the Lord. And so it's interesting to see Lord Shiva's wife, that she didn't mind her husband becoming so ecstatic, but she encouraged him.
这是非常有趣的，因为主Shiva的妻子呢，并不在意看到她的丈夫变得狂喜，而且还相反鼓励她的丈夫。
Even before Lord Shiva had stood up, while she was still sitting on his lap, she had begun to play music, to sing for him.
甚至在主Shiva起身之前，他还坐在自己的丈夫的大腿上的时候，他就开始弹奏起乐器，而且放声高歌。
So then, the group of people who they'd heard singing, that he saw them appear, they came in his sight, and he saw that they were very attractive people, and they all had four arms, and they were young, and they were very charming and attractive.
非常有年轻，年轻英俊，非常有魅力，吸引人。
Now some of Lord Shiva's servants, some of his companions, they also had four arms, but they were not as beautiful as these people who had appeared.
主Shiva的一些追随者们呢，也有四臂，但是可不像来的这些人那么美丽。
And the bodies of these people who were appearing, their bodies were they were effulgent, and they made the followers of Lord Shiva almost invisible because they were so effulgent.
而且这些远处走过来的这群人呢，他们的躯体都是浑身散发着光芒。
And they were all absorbed in singing the glories of the Supreme Lord. Everything about these people was very wonderful, and their decorations on their body and everything was so nice and so attractive.
有关于这群这些人的一切都是那么美妙，连他们身上的事物都那么美丽吸引力。And
in the company of them were also the four brothers, the four Kumaras. They were also there with them.
在他们中间呢，也有 Kumaras 兄弟。
So the four Kumaras there, we heard before, they reside on Tapaloka. Gop Kumar had gone there and he'd met them there. And so the four Kumaras, they are empowered incarnations of the Lord. So they are very special. They can travel many places. So seeing these people in such ecstasy, that Gop Kumar also became ecstatic, and he could not think of anything else. He couldn't think of anything, just only these people.
看到这群人那么狂喜, Gopakumar 自己也开始变得极乐起来, 他现在已经想不起任何事情了。
But after a short time, he came back to his normal consciousness, but he couldn't make himself ask these people if he could become their servant.
提出这样的问题,
he felt too afraid or too embarrassed to ask them because he thought it's not likely that they will accept me.
因为他觉得很害怕，觉得很窘迫来提向他们发问，因为他不能肯定他害怕他们不接受自己.
Because he thought, you know, he thought I'm just an insignificant person. I have no qualification to be a servant of these people who are coming from Vaikuntha. And so he couldn't ask them about joining them.
所以他就没办法张口来向他们来提出这种请求，跟他们加入他们的行列。But
Lord Shiva, he embraced them, and when he embraced them, then he would become even more ecstatic. He would awaken his love for Krishna.
主Shiva此时就拥抱了这群人，他。
So Gop Kumar was he was thinking that, oh, it would be very wonderful if these people would talk to me, that if they would give me their blessings, if they would be merciful, if by the mercy of Lord Shiva, these people somehow they may talk to me.
Gop Kumar 就心想, 这群人，他们也许会跟我谈话，那也许给我祝福，给我仁慈。那即使主Shiva的仁慈呢，他们这些人呢，可能会跟我说话吧。He
knew they must be great souls, but he wasn't sure where they had come from.
他知道这些人一定是伟大灵魂，但却不知道他们是来自哪里。So.
Lord Shiva's wife, Uma, also the name of Lord Shiva's wife, Uma, she understood what Gop Kumar was thinking. So she always acts according to the desire of her husband, Lord Shiva. So she had Ganesh. Ganesh is like the son of Lord Shiva and Parvati. So she had Ganesh come and speak to Gop Kumar.
Mm.
So Ganesh came to speak to Gopkumar in a very soft voice because he's going to say something very confidential. He doesn't want everyone to hear.
Ganesh 便过来, 非常柔声轻声地跟, Gopkumar 讲话, 因为他现在要讲的是非常机密的地址, 他可不想让别人听见。
So Ganesh tells Gopkumar, these people are associates of the ruler of Vaikuntha, the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna.
他就跟Gopkumar说道,这群人,他们是Vaikuntha的统治者,Sri Krishna,是尊主Sri Krishna的同游。
So they have bodily forms similar to the form of the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna. And they have come from Vaikuntha itself. So Ganesh tells Gopkumar, you should not doubt. These people have come from the spiritual world. And then Ganesh says that these other Vaikuntha companions, these other people, they're traveling in this small universe. Because this universe only has a four-headed Brahma. So they're so kind that they're traveling in this small universe. But there's another universe where there's an eight-headed Brahma, twice as large. And there are people traveling there. And there's another universe where Brahma has 16 heads. And there's also people visiting there. So Ganesh wants to show to Gopkumar that these visitors from Vaikuntha are very special. And there's many of these messengers from Vaikuntha going to visit other universes.
有许多像这样的外昆德的信使就拜访不同的宇宙。
So then Ganesh showed Gopkumar many of the Vaikuntha companions of the Lord traveling in all these different universes.
Ganesh 就像, Gopkumar 表明有许多Vaikuntha的同伴们在不同的宇宙旅行。
And there were millions and billions of universes.
宇宙有上百个宇宙，是上亿个宇宙。
And there were Brahmas with millions and billions of heads.
在这些 宇宙当中的Brahma有上百个头，有上亿个头。And
the Vaikuntha devotees, they were coming to these different universes, they would take a suitable body for living in that universe, for entering into that universe.
来自Vaikuntha的奉献者们，去他们去这些宇宙的时候，会采取，会变成。
So there are so many universes in the material world. we can understand how small and how insignificant we are.
所以有这么多不同的物质宇宙，我们可以设想我们，我们可以明白我们是多么渺小，多么的微不足道。
Because Gop Kumar was in the abode of liberation, so he could see all the material universes.
因为 Gop Kumar 他现在身处在解脱之地，所以能看到所有的物质宇宙。
And he saw how the Vaikuntha messengers could take the different forms suitable for that atmosphere.
他能看到百昆特的信使们可以采取不同的变化成不同的形象，以适合不同的大戏。
Yeah, they have to take the form, and they have to be the same size as the other inhabitants of the universe. Otherwise, it would not work. They would be too strange. So when they come to visit the universe, they will take a suitable form and a suitable size.So that they can enter into the universe.
他们必须要变化，就是把自己变成恰当的形象，正确的尺寸、身高，来进入宇宙的不同的宇宙。
And then people will respect them as the servants of Lord Narayan.
当那些宇宙的居民们就会。
So Ganesh is explaining to Gop Kumar about these Vaikuntha people. He said they only desire devotional service to the Lord.
Ganesh 向 Gop Kumar 解释，这些 Vaikuntha 的居民们只渴望对至尊主的奉爱。
They travel wherever they like to go, and wherever they go, they spread pure devotion.
无论他们旅行到哪里，他们都是在传扬纯粹的奉爱。
And they save the devotees from all the fears, even at the time of death.
甚至在奉献者的死亡之际，他们会拯救奉献者免除恐惧感。
Even one may not have had much devotion, but if he chanted the holy name somehow on the tongue of his tongue, and somehow he's heard something of the Lord's name in his ears, then they can get the mercy of the Lord.
即便他们这些，即便灵修之人，他们没有很多的奉爱。但是倘若他们唱诵了圣名，他们舌头上唱诵了主的名字，听到了圣名，也能得到主的仁慈。
Of course, devotees are not afraid of anything, but they're afraid of some obstruction. Some people try to stop their devotion. So the Vaikuntha men come and they encourage the devotees.
虽然奉献者是无惧无畏的。但是呢，他们却担心有对于他们奉爱的一些阻碍，因此就这些百昆特的居民们就前来鼓励奉献者们。
And even one's only chanted once, and maybe he chanted jokingly or not very serious, but he can get the mercy of these people from Vaikuntha.
即便就是。他们人们只是唱诵了一次圣名，他们开玩笑的唱诵，或者不是特别认真的唱诵，也能得到来自Vaikuntha的居民的仁慈。
And the four Kumaras, they are also the Lord's incarnations as devotees, and they also wander, distributing devotion.
四库马尔兄弟是主的化身，是主的化身。他们也四处旅行来传扬奉爱。
And they encourage and give security to people who feel sometimes they feel the absence of Lord Narayan.
他们会鼓励人们，会给那些感到。
Gop Kumar may be wondering why the four Kumaras were coming with the Vaikuntha residents. But the four Kumaras are Shaktivesha avatars, so they're empowered by the Lord.
可是库马尔斯兄弟呢，他们是主，Shaktivesha Avatar，是主，被赋权力的化身。And
wherever they go, they also teach about the worship of the Lord and devotion to Lord Narayan.
无论他们走到哪里，他们都会教导人们崇拜主，崇拜至尊主，崇对Narayan怀着奉爱。Yeah.
The four Kumaras spend most of their time on that planet Tapaloka, which is above heavenly planets, because the people doing the yoga there, they need their guidance. But the Kumaras, by being there, they speak about the Lord and they encourage them in the chanting of the Lord's glories. Sometimes the Lord disappears from their vision.
有的时候主从他们的视野当中会消失。
They have to meditate on him and see him in meditation.
他们必须要冥想主。
So these four Kumaras, they had just gone to Vaikuntha and they had seen the Lord there.
所以库马尔斯兄弟刚刚去了Vaikuntha，在Vaikuntha见到了主。
They got so much bliss there, much greater than any happiness you could ever get from liberation.
他们获得的这种极乐是远远高于解脱获得的快乐。And
they got the association of the devotees of the Lord. They could taste the nectar of pure devotion.
他们得到了主的奉献者的怜悯，他们感受到了纯粹奉爱的甘露。So
Lord Vishnu attracts everyone. But he attracts also even people like the four Kumaras, who are self-realized souls. So Ganesh said, he tells Gop Kumar, it's hard for me to say any more about Vaikuntha. It's so wonderful. It's so much, there's so much joy, there's so much opulence, it's inconceivable. And the Lord's always there with his goddess of fortune, so makes the people, the devotees there can always see the Lord with his goddess of fortune, and devotees, they can experience the pleasure of Vaikuntha. So Vaikuntha is place for the devotees, but not for those people who want to be liberation or simply want to become one. So this way Ganesh has told Gop Kumar everything about Vaikuntha.
就这样, 告诉了有关于跟这外昆特的一切。
And he tell, of course, told them materialists who are attached to the Brahman, they cannot go there.
他说，依附 Brahman 的物质主义者是无法进入那里。
And if somebody thinks they're the Parabrahman, if they think they're God, then they definitely can't go there.
倘若有人自以为自己是 Parabrahman。这样的人是确定无疑去不了那里的。
So Ganesh tells Gop Kumar, he said, if you get the real mercy of my father, you will hear the glories of Vaikuntha, and you can go there and see them for yourself.
Ganesh 告诉 Gop Kumar, 如果您真正获得了我的父亲的仁慈的话，那从他那里聆听了关于 Vaikuntha 的荣耀。那您自己就能亲身去那里了。
So receiving the mercy of Lord Shiva is not just going to Shiva Loka, but in going to Vaikuntha to see Lord Vishnu to get pure devotion.
因此，获得主 Shiva 的仁慈，那实际上就是去 ，sorry 吗？就是去Vaikuntha那里来得到对至尊者的纯粹奉爱。
So when Gop Kumar heard this, he was very eager to go to that place. He wants to go to Vaikuntha.
Gop Kumar 听完之后，他现在是特别渴望想去Vaikuntha了。
And he began to dance in ecstasy.
他在狂喜当中跳起舞来。
Okay, we'll stop here today.
好，我们来看一下问题。
Okay, any questions?
那第一个问题，比较真正的问题，大清妈大姐，那我先读一下。
可以，看着不太方便是吧？
对。
啊，我来读吧，可以。第一个问题是扰人旁布的问题。感谢马哈拉扎，感谢翻译主持。在《博迦干戈当要旨》当中，圣帕姆帕斯德说，只有主威士努赐予解脱，主阿玛布。比解脱更高的分爱 Hare Krishna 可以听到吗
OK 可以
听
我没有听声音断了
刚才声音断了是吗、我再重新说一下染日帕布问在博迦梵歌的要旨当中圣帕帕德说只有主威士努能够赐予解脱主希望和布拉玛不能刚才在讲课当中就谈到了主希望可以赐予人对神的奉爱但是他想问就是不如果能够赐予比解脱更高的奉爱不能赐予解脱这个比较令人困惑请马拉着给解释谢谢
你可以翻译
Yes, I asked that inIn Bhagavad Gita, it said that only Lord Vishnu can give liberation. Lord Shiva cannot give liberation. But here in your lecture, you mentioned Lord Shiva can give devotion to Lord. So the devotion to the Supreme Lord is much higher than liberation. Then if one has 100 yuan, but cannot give out 50 yuan,So that's, I feel very puzzled. Can you explain it kindly?
Well, your example. Liberation is not important, not significant for the devotee. Because they're engaged in devotional service, devotional service begins on the liberated platform.
解脱对于奉献者而言呢，并不是那么重要显著的，而对至尊主的奉爱是起始于解脱的层面。
The pleasure of liberation is just, there's no pleasure there at all, it's just only no suffering.
对于 解脱呢，实际上是没有什么 快乐而言的，它只不过是没有痛苦。
Lord Shiva can give liberation if that's what you want. We heard Lord Shiva can fulfill material desires, he can give liberation, he can also give pure devotion.
我们在讲课当中一开始提到了，鲁西瓦可以给予物质的快乐，可以给予解脱，也可以给予奉爱。
It's up to what do you want to get from Lord Shiva?The mood of the worshipper, the person who worships Lord Shiva, what does he desire?
这取决于崇拜主 Shiva 的崇拜者是处于什么样的心态，他想要什么。
If you just simply want liberation, he can give you that.
如果一个人他只想要解脱，主 Shiva 是可以给予的。
Who said he couldn't give liberation? I never said that.
谁说他不能赐予解脱了？从来没有这么说呀。
我不知道，然而帕布说是在波迦梵歌的要旨当中，但是我不知道是哪个世界的要旨当中。
哦，在波迦梵歌要旨中。
对。
他在说什么 ？Rajendra 说什么 ？Guru Mani 给我翻译。我要听，再听一遍。
Yes, the Prabhupada said that in the purport of Bhagavad Gita, it is said that only Lord Vishnu can give liberation. Lord Shiva cannot give liberation.
Ah, okay. That is Prabhupada's talking about.Liberation into the spiritual world. He's talking about a different kind of liberation.
Liberation into the spiritual world, not liberation. I didn't catch the latter part.
Prabhupada is describing how liberation, speaking of liberation on a different level, there's different ways in which we can understand liberation.So when Prabhupada says like that, he's talking about liberation into the spiritual world.
所以实际上就是解脱是有不同层次的解脱。当帕帕德谈到在这里谈的解脱呢，是指的进入灵性世界的解脱。
So liberation on the highest level is entering into the spiritual world in your original.Spiritual body, so that kind of liberation. Lord Shiva won't give that.
所以在最高层面的解脱呢，是指的进入灵性世界，恢复原本的原本的躯体。所以主 Shiva 是不能给予这样的解脱的。
But Lord Shiva can help us to develop our devotion for Lord Krishna.
然而主 Shiva 确实是可以帮助我们发展对主 Krishna 的奉爱之情。
But Prabhupada is speaking there about people who worship Lord Shiva with the desire for just simply moksha, sayujya mukti. Prabhupada is talking, like people, generally people who worship Lord Shiva, they don't want pure devotion, they just simply want sayujya mukti, they want impersonal liberation.
帕帕的在要旨当中呢，就是帕帕说的是，那就崇有的人崇拜主 Shiva， 他们只想要 moksha， 他们并不要纯粹的奉爱，他们想要的是 sayujya mukti， 非人格的解脱。
So generally the people who worship Lord Shiva, they have material desires or they're impersonalists.
一般而言呢，崇拜主 Shiva，有的人崇拜主 Shiva，他们怀着物质的欲望，他们想要非人格解脱。
So they don't get the real liberation.
这样的人是获得不了真正的解脱。
Real liberation is entering into the spiritual world in your spiritual body.
真正的解脱是以您灵性的身体进入灵性的世界。
So there's different levels of different ways in which we can use the word liberation to describe things in different ways. We can simply talk about liberation as getting free from the modes of nature.
有的时候谈到解脱是指的是摆脱物质自然形态的影响。
But we can also talk about liberation, we heard getting free of birth and death.
我们也可以就是以摆脱生死这个角度来谈，涉及到解脱。
And we're hearing this chapter in the Brihad Bhagavatamrita is about the abode of liberation, Mahakalapur. It's beyond the covering of the universe, but it's not in the spiritual world.
那在这一章当中，我们也听到了有关于Mahakalapur这个地方解脱之地，它已经是在物质宇宙之外了，但它还在灵性世界之下。
So, the highest liberation is going into this back to Godhead.
最高的解脱是回归神首。So
Lord Shiva doesn't give that kind of liberation.
主 Shiva 是不能赐予这样的解脱。
Okay, 下一个问题。
好的。 我们下一个问题是喜宝丹大吉的，顶拜咕噜翻译。自从走进奎什那知觉之后，我发现，在朝圣或者经历生活中的一些困难的时候，更能发自内心的呼唤神，并且真实的感觉到神的存在。请问，在平凡琐碎的生活中，如何能保持这种知觉呢？谢谢。
Should I translate?
Yeah.
Yes, this is Sibam Mataji asked that since she got contact with Krishna consciousness, she had experienced that during the pilgrimage to the Holy Dham or in the time of difficulty, she can call out to the Holy Name with more sincerity. So she asked, so how to keep that of mood in the ordinary daily life.
Mm. Well, you have to keep hearing and reminding yourself of the importance of spiritual life.
您需要不断的聆听，提醒自己，灵性生活至关重要。
We have to have the desire to want to get out of the material world.
我们必须要怀着要摆脱物质世界的愿望。
And when you went to the Holy Dham, or when you're in difficulty, you understand Krishna is there to help you.
当您去了圣地，或处在困境当中，您意识到Krishna就在那里帮着您。
So you should understand Krishna is always there with you. When you're happy, when you're comfortable, he's always there with you, and you have to thank him for putting you into a nice situation.
Krishna 感觉良好的时候，您要知道，就是您应该感恩 Krishna 给了你这么好的体验。
So you have to practice remembering Krishna by sadhana bhakti. That's what we talk about. Sadhana bhakti, this program for hearing and chanting, will help you to remind yourself of the importance of service to Krishna. You have to
remember Krishna, sadhana bhakti.
Don't just only wait until the trouble comes and then you call to Krishna. Think of Krishna now, thank Krishna.That he's taking care of you, he's guiding you, he's with you, he's watching you. Be conscious of him.
现在就想着，就要想着 Krishna， 感谢 Krishna， Krishna 一直在照料着您，指导您，跟您在一起看顾着您。您要意识到 Krishna。
Okay.还有问题吗？
有问题，今天问题挺多，好的问题。下一个问题是，忍帕布问的，每个宇宙中的主希瓦与在马哈斯瓦拉达尔玛中的萨达希瓦的形象和装束一样吗？都是带着骨灰花环，舌缠绕于脖颈，浑身涂抹的骨灰的这样的形象吗？
No. Sada Shiva is not going to be like Lord Shiva here.
No, Sada Shiva is not the same.
But generally, Lord Shiva in the material world, he'll be like that, yeah. In
general, the Lord Shiva is like that.
下一个问题。
下一个问题是，Divya Shakti 的提问的，Guru 好，我有一个问题，一位奉献者去另一位奉献者家里帮忙打扫卫生，这位奉献者家里是有神坛的，我想问，这是奉献服务吗
？Yes。
是。
Yeah, you serve a devotee. That's just like serving Krishna.
您在服务奉献者，那就是在服务 Krishna.
It's even better than service to Krishna. To serve Krishna's devotees is even more important than service to Krishna.
比服务 Krishna 更好，服务 Krishna 的奉献者比服务 Krishna 本人更重要。
There was one devotee, he was in a temple and he was a pujari and he was serving the deity and he could talk to the deities. So he asked the deity, will I get liberated at the end of this life? The deity said no. So he said, why not? He said, because you never serve the devotees.
这位普扎瑞就问他服侍的神像，我在这一生结束之后，我能不能得到解脱呢？神像说不能。他说为什么呢？神像说因为您从来没有服务过奉献者。
So he understood. He left the temple and he went and he found a place far away and he found some Vaishnavas and secretly he would.The Vaishnavas, they didn't want to take service from him because they knew he was a devotee. They knew he was an advanced devotee. They didn't want him to serve them. So he had to be very secret and he would serve them, find ways to serve their cows, to clean their cows, and take care of their barn, the cow barn.
然后这个奉献者呢，他就离开了庙，就找到了一个偏远的地方，就秘密的服务 Vaishnava。因为呢 ，Vaishnava 知道他是一个伟大的进步的奉献者，不想接受他的服务，所以他就悄悄找了这么一个奉献 Vaishnava， 就是服务这个 Vaishnava 的母牛，为母牛清洁身体，清理这个牛圈。
So you're very lucky you got to serve a devotee. Maybe you can tell me who it was, and maybe I can also go there and I can get to do some service.
您特别幸运，就是您可以找到一个服务奉献者的机会，也许您应该告诉我，我也能够有机会服务奉献者。
Hare Krishna. 下一个问题。
下一个问题，饶真正帕布。宇宙毁灭之后，宇宙中的主希瓦去了哪里？去哪里逍遥了
？Well, Lord Shiva has his abode is beyond the material world, right? When the material worlds are annihilated, Lord Shiva has his own abode. That's eternal.
主希瓦呢，在这个物质宇宙之上，他有自己的居所，对吧？所以当这个物质宇宙毁灭之后，他回他自己的居所了。
Waits for the next creation.
等待下一次创造。
Okay.
下一个问题 ，Panchatattva Prabhu。感谢 Maharaj 的精彩讲述，感谢翻译主持人。Gopal Kumar 和 Kumar 四兄弟，还有主希瓦，谁的地位最高？现在念诵 Hare Krishna Mantra 的奉献者能够得到他们的祝福吗
？Yes, chanting Hare Krishna, you'll get the blessings of all of these devotees.
是的，唱诵 Hare Krishna, 您可以得到上述所有这些奉献者的祝福了。
They're all pure devotees.
他们全是纯粹奉献者。
But they have different services.
只是服务不同而已。
Gopkumar, he's still doing sadhana. He hasn't reached perfection yet. We're hearing about his life. So he's still doing sadhana. He has not yet come to perfection.
Gopkumar, 他还在履行自己的 sadhana 呢，他还没有达到完美呢。我们将听到他的这个生活，他还在做 sadhana。
But the four Kumaras, they're perfect beings, they're Shaktavesha avatars. They're empowered by the Lord to distribute Krishna consciousness.
而 Kumaras, 四兄弟，他们是完美的人物了，他们是 Shaktavesha avatar.
And Lord Shiva, he is almost Vishnu.Not quite. Vishnu is the milk and Lord Shiva is the yogurt. Haribo?
Haribo?
Yogurt can never become milk. So Lord Shiva can never become Vishnu, but Vishnu can become Lord Shiva.
主希瓦是永远不能变成主威水，但威水呢能变成主希瓦。
So Lord Shiva is an expansion of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
主希瓦是至尊主的扩展。
He's not usually an ordinary jiva, but sometimes a jiva becomes Shiva.Not usually. Usually Shiva is not Jiva.
一般而言呢，主 Shiva 都不是个体灵魂能充当的。有的时候，有的个体灵魂能够充当主 Shiva。
Okay, but we can get the blessings of all of them by chanting Hare Krishna.
但无论如何，通过唱诵 Hare Krishna， 我们能够得到他们的祝福。
还有问题吗？
他们三位谁的地位更高呢？最高。
Well, Lord Shiva is almost God, not quite God. The four Kumaras are Jivas who are empowered by the energy of God. And Gop Kumar, he's a Jiva. And the four Kumaras are empowered Jivas, right? They're Shakya Vishava, it means empowered, the living entities who are empowered to do special service for the Lord. So Lord Shiva is supreme.
所以这三者当中，主 Shiva 是最高。
It's above the four Kumaras, above Gop Kumar.
主 Shiva 比Kumar 四兄弟比 Gopa Kumar 都高。
OK， 下一个问题。
好的，好的，下一个问题。Chaitanya Charan Prabhu， Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， 顶拜奉献者，听了 Shiva 神的情况，对他有了更多的理解和信心，但觉得崇拜 Shiva 神还是不如崇拜 Krishna 好，崇拜 Shiva 还是有危险，比如 Shankarshan 是 Shiva 化身，他对他的追随者说 Krishna 是至尊人格守神，可他们都不遵照他的教导，所以我还是对 Krishna 比较有感情。当然 Shiva 我也感觉很亲切，只想崇拜 Krishna， 可以吗？
Yes, you can just worship Krishna. You don't have to worship Shiva. But we have to respect Lord Shiva. We offer our respects to Lord Shiva. You don't have to worship him if you don't feel inclined.But you do have to offer respects to him.
可以，就是，但是你要尊重主 Shiva。您可以不崇拜他，但是就是可以对他没有什么形象，但是应该尊重他。
And we should not dislike somebody who worships Lord Shiva. You should not have a low opinion of them, but you should understand Lord Shiva is not different from Krishna.
有的人他们崇拜主 Shiva， 你也不应该对这些人呢，就是把他们看得很低，对他们就是有这种比较低的认识，因为主 Shiva 和主 Krishna 一样。
OK， 还有问题吗？
还有的，下一个问题，田慧霞。马大吉 ，Hare Krishna 老师，顶拜您的莲花组，请问有时候说 Krishna 的化身，有时候又听到 Krishna 的扩展，化身和扩展是一样的吗？如果不一样，它们有什么区别？祈求老师告知，谢谢。
A difficult question to answer. I've never been very sure of this myself.But anyway, avatar means something which descends, which comes down. So the avatars, they come down from the spiritual world.
Avatar 的意思就是降凡，所以就是从灵性世界。
They come
降凡。
Yeah.There are different kinds of avatars. We said you can have a Shaktyavesha avatar, one can be empowered, a living entity, an ordinary living entity can be empowered to be a Shaktyavesha avatar, to do wonderful work on behalf of Krishna.
其中一种是 Shaktyavesha Avatar， 是被赋予了权力、赋予了能量的一个生物体，他们可以做奇妙的事情。他
Then you have yoga avatars, and every yoga there's an avatar. And you have also guna avatars, there's the three gunas, and there's an avatar in charge of each of the gunas. So like this, there are different kinds of avatars, but expansions, well, we have people, oh, we have also Purusha avatars, we have the three Purushas, they're also avatars.
另外一种是 Purusha avatar, 有三个 Purusha avatar.
So I've never been able to understand exactly where the distinction lies between the avatar and the expansion.
那我自己就从来没有就是能够确定确切的理解就是扩展和化身二者的区别。
But if you find out, you can let me know.
您要是知道了，您就告诉我。Okay,
下一个问题，也是一位奉献者，新奉献者的热爱生命，顶拜Guru，顶拜翻译，主Shiva给予的解脱，也就可以理解为非人格的解脱，对吗？顶拜您，Hare Krishna。
Yes, right. Usually when Shiva, people who worship Lord Shiva, they want that impersonal liberation.
是的，一般有就是崇拜主Shiva的人，他们想要的是非人格的解脱。
But most people who worship Shiva, they don't want impersonal liberation. They simply want material desires. They want to get their material senses satisfied.
然而大部分主持的崇拜者呢，他们只是想要满足他们的物质欲望，满足他们的感官。It's
rare that somebody wants liberation.
真正想要解脱的这种，是非常罕见的。I
met one man, he told me, he said, Krishna is not God, he said Shiva is God, and then he said Shiva is light.
我曾经在通比这个地方曾经遇到一个人，他告诉我，Krishna不是神，Shiva才是神，Shiva是光。
So of course his desire is to enter into that light, to merge in the light. He thinks energy is the supreme.
他进入那个能量，他认为这光是至高无上的。
So they don't understand the personal feature of the Supreme. Okay, 还有问题吗?
我们还有两个问题，三个，还有三个问题。果然顶拜咕噜顶拜翻译，在圣地不小心被一位帕布顶拜，还摸了双足。 我要回拜他，他不让。听说这些业报会反映到被顶拜的人身上，产生业报，是这样吗？ Hare Krishna.
Can you give me translation, Guru Maharaj?
Yes. So Gaurangi Maharaji, when she went to the holy dam, there was a Prabhu paid up obeisance to her and even touched her feet, and she heard that whoever she had to bear the karma of that person.
Yes.
When she want to pay obeisance back to that Prabhu won't let her to do that.
Yeah, but you have to do it. Even though he doesn't want to let you do it, you have to do it.
就即便他不想让您回拜他，那您也必须要回拜他。
better not to let anybody touch your feet. And if somebody touches your feet, you should want to touch their feet. So be careful. You have to be careful. When people offer respect, you should offer the respect back.
所以你要小心, 如果有人要顶拜您, 您必须要回拜。
Even they don't want you to respect them, you should do it anyway. When Lord Chaitanya was in the temple in Jagannath Puri, and they were cleaning the temple, and one man came with a bucket of water, and he poured the water on the feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then he drank the water. Lord Chaitanya told the devotees, take this man out of the temple. Don't let him stay in the temple because he doesn't behave properly. So especially in the temple, if you're in the temple, we offer our respect to the deity.
通常呢, 在庙宇呢, 我们是顶拜神像。
So in the temple, you don't need to offer obeisances to the guru, we just offer obeisances to the deity.
所以在庙里呢, 我们不顶拜guru, 我们是顶拜神像。
And when people respect us, we want to respect them.
当人们来向我们致敬, 我们也, 我们反过来要向他们致敬。
And somebody touches your feet, and they won't let you touch their feet, so then you take the dust where they have stood, and you take the dust from the spot where they have stood, and you take that dust and put it on your head.
如果您就是反过来要回拜，有人要顶拜了您以后，您想回拜他们，他们就又不让的话，您就要从他站的那个地方就取那个尘土啊，把那尘土放在自己头上。
And that way you will neutralize the effects of their karma which they've given you.
以这种方式，您就可以中和他们给您的karma了。
Okay, Shai Gawanti.
Shai Gawanti is Shurabhima. 请问Guru, 在圣典伯加瓦坛当中说到, Rudra 是主希望的扩展, 请问这些Rudra 是主希望的亲身, 或是直接的扩展, 还是被授权的个体灵魂希望?
Translate.
In Srimad Bhagavatam, it said that Rudras are expansion of Lord Shiva. May I ask that are these Rudras personal expansion, direct expansion of Lord Shiva, or they are Rudras, or they are Jiva, are they Jivas?
Well, Lord Shiva, he's a special Tattva. He's not Vishnu Tattva, he's Shiva Tattva. So I don't know where the Rudra, I never heard that they were Jivas. If they're expansions of Lord Shiva, they will be the same as Lord Shiva.
So Shiva, he's Shiva Tattva,
he's
Jiva 就是一个特殊的范畴，它不是主 Vishnu 的 part 吧？我从来没听说 Shiva 是 Shiva， 所以如果是这样的话，那么既然 Rudra 是 Shiva 的扩展，那么他们就跟 Shiva 是一样的。
那比 Shiva Shiva type， 他们 ，Yeah， they're not they're not Jivas and they're not Vishnu also， they're in between。There's
Rudra， 所以Rudra 那他们就是 Shiva 的扩展，他们属于 Shiva 范畴，他们既不属于 Vishnu 范畴，也不属于 Shiva 范畴，他们属介于这二者之间。
OK， 下一个问题。
好，下一个问题，阎摩那提染玛德吉，顶拜公入，顶拜翻译。Durga 女神能创造、维系和毁灭整个物质能量，那么她和主 Brahma、主 Vishnu、主 Shiva 三者在履行职责上有什么关系呢？他们地位分别有什么不同呢？
嗯。Yeah, interesting question.
问题非常有意思。
Difficult for us to appreciate exactly how everything works, but somehow Durga is in charge of the material nature. Right? And Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva, they have a particular job in the universe.
所以就是我们怎么去理解他们的工作，这个是很难的。但是呢，有多个女神，她是掌管物自然，而 Rama、Vishnu、Shiva， 他们都有不同的各自的工作。
Mother Durga is the personification of the material nature. The material nature works under her direction, and she's under the direction of the Supreme Lord.
所以，Durga 母亲，她是物质自然的化身，她是在至尊主的工作，在至尊主下面来工作的。
And the Lord has his guna avatars. We said guna avatars. Brahma is in charge for creation. Vishnu for the maintenance, and Shiva for the destruction.
我们在刚才说到了主有不同的Guna Avatar属性化身， Brahma 他负责创造， Vishnu 负责维系，主需了毁灭。
The three modes of nature: goodness, passion and ignorance. Goodness is for maintenance, passion for creation, and ignorance for destruction.
有三个属性，善良、激情、愚昧。善良是维系，激情创造，愚昧是毁灭。
So, Mother Durga is there in the beginning for the help. She's responsible, helping with the creation.
所以，母亲 Durga， 她是一开始就在那里协助着创造。
Lord Shiva also helps.
主 Shiva 也是在那里协助着。
Lord Shiva carries the glance of Lord Vishnu, right? When Lord Vishnu impregnates the material nature.
主 Shiva 是携带着主 Vishnu 的瞥视，就是主 Vishnu 他当他让物质自然受孕的时候。
So then, Brahma, he's doing secondary creation.
而主 Brahma 呢，他在从事的是二级创造。
Initial creation is already done for him. He's just the engineer. Brahma comes along and starts putting things together. But the initial creation is done with the help of Durga.
Brahma 只是工程师而已，他来呢就是把所有的事情都攒在一起。 而 Durga 女神呢，妈妈她是在初期创造的时候，在那里已经帮助了初期的创造。
So Mother Durga is like the shadow of the Lord, right? She moves under the direction of her master, Lord Vishnu.
Durga 女妈妈呢，就是主的像主的影子一样。
他是在主的指导之下、指令之下来移动的。OK，还有问题吗？嗯，Gurudev，我们还有最后一个问题。嗯，聆听，马德西，请问咕噜，有一个比较新的奉献者，总是以他的要求打扰我，我没有理他，结果他就把我给删除了。这是我对他的冒犯吗
？Yes。
是的。
Some new devotee is coming. You should take time to try to encourage them and help them to become Krishna conscious.
一些新人来，您得花时间鼓励他们，帮助他们具有 Krishna 知觉。
Don't neglect them. Give them a chance.
不要忽视他们，给他们机会。
Try to help them, try to satisfy them, try to encourage them. Devotees are not many, and if we don't encourage the new people, then we will never expand Krishna consciousness.
要努力帮助他们，满足他们，鼓励他们。如果不鼓励他们，我们的Krishna知觉永远不会扩展。
You should think you're very fortunate that a new devotee is coming to you for help. You're very lucky. Krishna is sending people to you, but you're ignoring them. You're not taking care of them. It's not very nice.
您应该觉得自己特别幸运，这些新人能来找您寻求帮助。您应该觉得很幸运，Krishna派人来了。 如果您忽视他们，不理他们，不照顾他们，这样不好。
So please, you try to help them.
所以，请您帮助他们。
And that way, you'll become very dear to Lord Krishna.
就这样的话，主 Krishna 就会十分钟爱您。
If you can bring one person to Krishna consciousness, you're doing a great service for Krishna.
如果您能把一个人带到Krishna知觉中来，您就是为Krishna做了伟大的服务。OK，没有问题啊。对，我们没有问题了，Gurudev。OK，谢谢大家
，Thank you very much， Hare Krishna， Srila Prabhupada ki，
加油。Go
back to Vrinda ki。 Guru Mani Sati Maniji is key. Soyo de function jerky. Jai.